Hi everybody, all my followers, welcome to another video. So this video today, again on this Volkswagen Golf MK7, I think it is, 2014 with the TDI engine. Still no important for the video today, but if you do follow my channel, you most likely have seen the video for the handbrake. And I would like to make a quick note on that video, even though I'm going to put on the description below of the other video, and I will leave a link for that video on the description of this video. I ended up by replace the connector. So the connector was only broken on the outside, so they actually bit that seals the plug. The connector was still intact. And the little tab that holds the connector in place was still intact. So it was only part of the outside of the connector that was broken. But I actually had some spares from other stuff, but it was the same connector. And so I ended up by getting it replaced. So the handbrake issue is sorted. And the next issue we are going to sort is going to be that lighting there. Okay. So there we go. Check brake wear. So most likely this is going to be a brake job. So we'll be changing the front brake pads and sensor. As I said on the other video, I walked around the car. The rear brake pads, they are low, but they're still okay for a few thousand miles. The front ones, they are indeed low. So let's gonna crack on with it. Let's gonna get these brake pads replaced. Okay, and the last one. And I don't think these bolts, they have ever seen any grease. Wow. Okay. As you can see, the pads are extremely low. Don't know about the inner one, but they are both quite low. And the sensor, I don't know how many sensors is. There is at least a sensor on this side. So, but yeah, let's open this and get the pads replaced. Take these caps off. This is a 7mm. Before we finish it off, let's gonna open the pads, open the caliper. Okay, and I do it like this. I already showed you. Slowly start to push it. Just make sure we are not placing the screwdriver anywhere where it's gonna make any damage. And
I think that's it, really. I think it's as far as it comes, or no? It comes a little bit more. I think that's it now. Should be it. Now let's kind of take the bolts off and remove the caliper. Okay, let's unplug the connector to start with. Other way, actually. Well, that was not very good. That was not very good. Okay. The pads are low anyway, so that needs changing. I'll show you. Yeah, the sensor is here. I'll show you in a second. Here is the sensor. And obviously, as you can see, the pads, they were already quite low. So let's clean everything. Let's clean everything and get the new pads. Pins are quite dry, so we're gonna get some grease on them. Okay, they've been cleaned and new grease. This is the second one. And now it's gonna get the brake pads. Okay, and before we put the pads, we'll put a little bit of copper grease around the main contact areas. Be able to get a new That's in. Let me clean my hands. Okay, let's try to put these pads back in place. This is the inner one. Up. Sensor. Vase. No, it needs to go on the first. That's it. Now we're in place. Okay, now let's kind of put the bolts back in, the pins, and that's nearly done. This side. Okay, job done on this side. And I did a mistake, don't know if anyone spotted that, but I've used, on the outside, I've used the wrong pad. So the pad, they came packed in pairs, but was actually the inner side pads on one pack and the outside pads on the other pack. I thought there would be one side on one pack, the other side, but it was not. So if you can see, the difference is pretty much just on these sort of tabs. Everything else is the same, the pad, but just the tabs are different. So took it off again, replaced with the right one. And now I'm not going to take you through the other side, but the other side, obviously, just same thing. And then should be it, really. Okay, and it's done both sides, and we'll be, so we'll turn the ignition on. Okay, and my light is gone already. That's sorry about that, guys. That's really good. So I don't know if there is any reset for the pads or if it just waits for the sensor. We'll go through the menus on the Maxxis anyway, just quick to see if there is anything that needs to be reset. Let's go to, there's no service here. Electric, probably, it might be that there isn't. Let's quick go to diagnosis, control unit. Let's go to dashboard. Don't know if it's gonna be on dashboard actually. Let's go to guided functions. All change, No, there isn't nothing for that. So it looks like there is nothing for brake pads. It looks like they only wait for the sensors to be triggered. And once the sensor is triggered, obviously, there's setting. No, it looks like there is nothing, guys, really. Let's just try to go guided functions, control unit. Oh, this is going to take me through there. Let me see if there's anything here. So, I could have searched this before. Service light reset. There is nothing here. Let's start. Oh, hold on. Replace the brake pads. So there is here for the brake pads. But this is for Audi A6, 8L and Q7, which is not here. This is not the case. So yeah, let's just start the engine and see if there's any funny lights. See if the light stays off. Yeah, light stays off. Let me press the, yeah, that's it. So the only last issue now, guys, or there is two issues. I don't know if I'm going to get both done, but the next issue now is going to be my engine light, which that's going to be on a separate video. So I think that's it for this brake pad replacement on a MK7 Volkswagen Golf. Nothing interesting, just a brake job, really. Still, hope there is some information here you guys are going to find it useful. I do really hope that you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, any comments, put them below, guys. And like always, thanks for watching.